video, we will discuss a question which was asked in JEE Mains 2014 on the topic vector products. The question is as follows: if mod A equals to 2, mod B equals to 3, and mod of 2A minus B equals to 5, then mod of 2A plus B equals to. In our introduction video, we had seen that if mod of 2A minus B is equal to 5, I can square on both sides. So this I can write it as mod of 2a whole square plus mod of b square minus 2 into 2 will be 4 times a dot b. A dot b I can again write it as mod a mod b cos of a comma b. This is equal to 5 square, which is 25. Now 2 I can take out, which will be 2 square 4. Mod a value is 2, 2 whole square will again be 4. Mod b value is 3, 3 square will be 9, minus this is 4 times mod a will be again 2, mod b will be again 3. This is cos of a comma b is unknown, we don't know the angle yet, equals to 25. This is 16 plus 9, 25, cancels. Now what is this? So this is 0, since this is 0 now, cos of a comma b is 0. Or a comma b is 90 degrees. Now using this, I need to calculate this. So mod of 2a plus b whole square under root will give me this. Since square and root will get cancelled, I will get my mod of 2a plus b. Now how can I write this? This I can write this as, again I can square. So this will be 4 times mod a square plus mod b square plus 2 into 2 is 4 times a dot b, which is mod a mod b cos of a comma b. Now we know that a comma b is 90 degrees. So this will get cancelled out and we are left with mod of 4 times mod a square. Mod a square is again 2 square, which is 4, plus mod b square. This is again 3 square, which is 3 into 3. 4 square is 16, 3 square is 9. Root 25, which is nothing but 5, which is option 3. So here we saw that by using the basic concepts of dot product, we could find out the angle, and that angle I could use to find out another relation. So this is how a question in JEE Mains 2014 can be solved by using the basic concepts of vector dot products. Thank you so much. In this video, we will talk about a question based on triple products which was asked in JEE Mains 2014. The question is as follows: if box of A cross B, B cross C, C cross A is lambda times box ABC, then what is the value of lambda? This is a property kind of a question. Whenever we observe properties kind of questions in triple products, I can assume A, B, C some values. I assume A value as I, B value as J, C value as K. These are my standard assumptions for any property based questions, provided the condition is not given. If a condition is given parallel or perpendicular, accordingly we need to take. Now if I substitute this, let's see what I'll get. So this is A cross B, which will be nothing but I cross J. B cross C, which will be what? J cross K. C cross A. C cross A is K cross I. We know that I cross J is nothing but K. J cross K is nothing but I. K cross I is nothing but J. And this I can also write it as lambda times box of I, J, K. Now we know that box ABC can be written as A cross B dot C, or you can also write this as A dot B cross, doesn't matter. So now LHS, I can write this as K cross I dot J. We know that K cross I is again J, so J dot J will be 1. So this box of KIJ is a standard value, which is 1. This is equal to lambda times box of IJK. Again, I can write this as I cross J dot K. I cross J, we know the value as K. And again, k dot k is also 1. So we got the value of lambda as 1 just by simply substituting a as I, b as j, c as k. So the answer is lambda equals to 1, which is the fourth option. Thank you very much.